I said, well, there's apologies for that, and so I have apologies from Councillor Harrington, Wilson and Stockton. Do I have any further ones? Okay, we accept those apologies. Thank you very much. I can remind members of any declarations of interest. Okay, thank you. Well, item three is the performance and review work plan. Yeah, sorry about that. It's not on the thing. So we have the minutes of the meeting of the 13th of July 2015. Can I ask for an agreement that the true and correct record? Okay, I'll sign that as such. Thank you. Thanks for that comment. So, and our item three is the well, there's just a couple of things from the last performance review. There's a couple of questions asked on the conditions of rail coverage. There's a paper out on some of the answers. One of the answers, what Councillor Stockton asked, we haven't got back yet, but Colin will bring that to us when that's answered. So at least all questions are being answered and responded to, so members aren't being left out. So back to item three on the performance of the review work now. Stephen, would have you please?
Certainly, thank you, Chair. This report just outlines what the work plan and the report schedule is for the performance and review committee for the rest of this year. You'll be aware that back in July we had a workshop where we discussed with members what some of the possible areas of focus they might want to look at during the course of the year. As part of that, we also investigated two task and finish group areas to look at. So to deal with the first section first, it's the, in terms of the work plan, follow the terms of reference, we looked at what the corporate plan was saying and what the travels were going to be expected to deliver last year and in the coming year. So we presented to the workshop a template and various suggestions of activity that they want to have a look at in detail, further detail than you perhaps get in some other reports to other committees. And that's highlighted and presented to you in the appendices there. All the officers, rather than heads of service, have been advised that these reports will be coming up, so they're all ready to go. So if you're happy with the contents of the reports and that you do want to see the information on these activities, you can just kind of agree that at the end of the meeting. One point to make, I guess, is obviously as time progresses and projects get delivered and delayed and other things come onto the agenda, you may want to, or you may want to, swap some of the projects around, which is again perfectly fine. We just need enough time to make sure that the relevant officers can prepare the reports. But as it stands from the workshop we held in July, these appear to be the projects that you would like to see through to March 2016. The second item we covered in the workshop was the task and finish groups. And so, two task and finish groups were decided to be appropriate to kind of follow up through the year. Each task and finish group will have various activities undertaken in terms of research into the subject matter. One task and finish group was about programme management and how we take that forward in Merseytravel and some of the benefits that we can make to it to ensure that we're on target, delivering our plans and performance, monitoring and reporting against it. And one was looking at long-term rail strategy review, how far we've got with it, some of the amendments we may need to make, what's happening in the future. Now, each of those task groups have been given a member who's responsible, and also I think there's been a discussion on which members are going to take part in which task and finish group. So just to summarise again, the report is your timetable of report you'll be receiving over the next year, subject to any comments, any amendments you may want to make, and also the terms of reference for the two task and finish groups, and also to agree the membership on those.
Thanks for that, Stephen. The memberships have been agreed. The good column, the names, as you know, they've been circulated there on this other separate email. So they're sorted out. It's just a matter of everybody's agreed where they want to be, how the task groups are going to be operated, and of course now what they've been looking for, the questions to be submitted and the timetable. So everybody's up to date, I think, on where we're going to now. So in terms of reference, the work plan, are we all happy with that? So, any questions? So, I'll hopefully in future we'll be getting the questions. Of course, if any questions, when the list of questions comes out, members, of course, can always have suggestions to have questions added, because we all see things in a different light, and of course we are looking at to, I can't say the word scrutiny, but we are looking at how to review this, but we need to get the right questions so we can get the right answers for the people we serve outside. Stephen, yeah.
Just to point out, thanks, Chair, for that. You're pointing out the detail that we need to have the process going forward. If you look at the methodology that has been highlighted under each of the terms of reference, it highlights the kind of general approach that's going to be taken, led through the two relevant heads of service. It also gives some of the names of people that are interviewed with users, kind of expert witnesses for part of this as well. So if you've got any comments on that, feel free to pass that through. As soon as the heads of service firmed up the timetables of the activities, any interview questions, etc., we'll pass that through to yourself, because we've also got on the work plan for the year certain dates where you will get updates on how the task completion groups are progressing.
Thanks for that, Stephen. As Stephen said, if anybody needs anything, as we start to progress, you've all got my email address, get in touch with me, give me a shout, and then I'll make sure that any suggestions or recommendations you've got can be fed right through to the officers to see if that's it, so that they can be included, so that we can have a good in-depth review of what we're doing. Are we all okay with that? Any questions on that?
Would you like me to read out the names of the two groups to make sure that there weren't doubts in the minutes?
Yeah, a bit trouble. Yeah, please, Carl, by all means.
Just to be so one's aware, final assistance programme management would be Councillor McGrath, Mr Chair, Councillor Wolfson, Howard, Carr, McKinley and Dodd. And the long-term rail group would be Councillor Stockton as Chair, Councillors Barrington, Thomas, Roberts and Councillor Dodd again. Okay.
Wonderful. Thank you very much for that, Colin. Once again, you see we're up and running, the whip's being cracked. So, are you okay with that? So, can we agree the recommendations on paragraph 2 of the report? Can we agree? Thank you. Now we come on to item 4, Merseytravel statistical annual update. Stephen, back to you again.
Thank you again, Chair. Hopefully members will be aware that this is a report that we issue every 6 months or so. Every 6 months it's a half year report. But what we've done over the last year or so is we've tried to kind of amend the way it's presented, because what we feel, I think members' feedback has been, is that there's some very useful key information in here that Merseytravel needs to be aware of in terms of how it develops its business and how it kind of, you know, some statistics and figures should influence how we go about the things that we do. The report is in a paper format at the moment, although obviously we email it around. And just overall, the aim is that we're going to bring this into an electronic kind of what we call a dashboard approach, so that in future you will get copies of the report, it will come to the committee, but you will be able to access it through your logon, Merseytravel logons, be able to access the information kind of much more quickly and at your fingertips whenever you need it. So you'll get it in both formats, electronically on screen, but also printed so you can reference it as and when you feel necessary. This information was collated by the performance team, because, as I say, part of the role of this information is to influence our performance, dictate what our strategy is going to be, where we need to have areas of focus, where we need to put our resources, and then to help track how well we're doing and make adjustments as and where necessary. Without going through some of the intricate detail of the report, there's probably just a few areas worth pointing out. As I say, my team compile the data, check the data, make sure that it's kind of as up to date and accurate as possible. The interpretation then of the data, what it actually means, is the responsibility of the individual service areas who know the detail of that. So what you will see throughout the document that you've seen before is kind of small quotes from the head of service with a little interpretation of what these things are meaning. So if ticket sales are going up, actually are going up or down, etc. I'll just have a brief comment about that. What the idea behind that is that if you see something in some of the figures that perhaps the short comment doesn't address, you can perhaps pick that up at this meeting and you can ask for more detail and we can refer that on to the relevant service data to answer your questions. As you can see, if you're looking at bus, for example, you've got increases in passenger numbers going from 0.1% over the last year but a 4.4 decrease since 2009-10. We've got cash journeys that are falling, more journeys going by prepaid ticketing. Obviously, you've got things like My Ticket that come into this, that was a superb, successful project. It also kind of takes various bits of patching out to other ticketing sales. And again, you would use that kind of information. If that's your policy to try and promote things like My Ticket and people's travel, great, it's the spot. And it allows you to kind of target down what exactly it is that you want to achieve. You've got things like, again, bus mileage decreasing, both on commercial and supported mileage. Matt Goggins has said in part of his statement there, it's about looking at how we can kind of decrease reliance on supported service and the mileage it does, but also look at new options and new ways of doing it under the resources that we've got at the moment and will continue to have. Again, I won't go through too much more of the details. There's quite a lot of information there. We've got information covered on the rail, tunnels, ferries, etc. The other question, or the other aspect, is if you wanted other information in here that isn't currently available, we're always willing to hear that, because we want to make the report contain the information that you find valuable to yourselves as members to kind of assess and help develop the travel policy. It doesn't mean we'll be able to grab the information straight away, although in some cases we may well be able to, but it allows us to set up a process to make sure you're getting the information that you want. As I said, I won't go through, but I've highlighted various areas that I've looked through. Any questions on this, the report, format, or any other kind of data collection? Happy to answer questions now. Anything that might be more specific about why certain things have changed, we'd have to refer them on to the expert areas. But as with the notes earlier that the chair read out, we'll get back to you as soon as possible with any answers to clarification.
Thanks for that, Stephen.
Just a comment,
also on that, there was another comment before on the heads of service, the comments from those, and also the photographs of them. You know, it brought members and people closer, I think, to that service, because you know, it shows you the person with the comments of them. But I think that's what he's how you say it, there's no comment there on that customer contact, is there?
Yeah, I think they got the answer to that one. In terms of the pictures, just to mention that what we did want to do with this, because we've had comments previously when we used to send this out, was just a lot of pages and films and texts.
Yeah.
Not very user-friendly, not very personable, not something you really want to read. Whereas with this, at least we've got a bit of narrative with it, we've got some data. Pictures of people, so if you see them in the corridor, you know you're talking, that just makes it a little bit more real. We're going to try and continue to enhance that, make it more open. In terms of the customer comments, I believe that whereas it's a new system, so one of the things that we are constantly trying to make sure works in these reports is when there's a new system that starts recording things differently, it gets difficult to be able to kind of make previous comparisons, etc. So if you would want to look at what the figures were previously, I'm sure we can get hold of these. But in terms of this, it was a new system, so we didn't want to refer back to what the data is that are previously.
I know, certainly not if we do extra work. It was just quite simply that one idea was to show the trends, and that didn't show the trend, I fully understand.
If you showed a trend which is based on two different standards. Of course, what you're saying, Harry, is the most important thing. It's our customers. And our customers, how they contact us, and how we measure that. So, yeah, thanks for that, Harry. Any further questions? Please, Patrick.
Thanks, Chair. I'm thinking about, forgive me, I've got a bit of a sore throat, going forward with potential changes through city, region and regional devolution. And my question is about gathering information on not only demand, but also on need. And a potential change in the way bus services are regulated in terms of being able to respond to need as well as respond to demand. At the moment, how, forgive my ignorance, I'm quite new on this committee, how does Merseytravel collect data on need as opposed to demand? I'm thinking about demographic profiling and particularly around age profiling, where communities have a high percentage of older folk who may not actually manifest themselves in terms of active demand, but there would still be a need there. And I'm also conscious through the Localism Act, lots of communities now are developing neighbourhood plans where they're actually doing this kind of research that may be useful for an organisation like Merseytravel going forward in terms of a different model of regional government where we could respond more to the needs of the people as well as respond to demand in the marketplace.
Yeah, I'm not saying so, but also with the cuts that happened from central government, we're going to rely more and more on local neighbourhood networks, which is what I just left this morning, and all these local neighbourhood plans. But they're going to be sometimes, well, they will be starting to drive the system, because as the city, region, councils start to lose their power to operate because of lack of funding, this is where it's going to start again. So, please, could you address that, please, to speak?
Yeah, certainly, to some extent at least. I think, yeah, it's very important that we know that people have got needs rather than just asking people who are already out there on the network and finding out what they want. Yeah, what other people who haven't got that voice, haven't got the access to the techniques we're using. Very basically, and it might be an issue that you might want to flag up as a report, something to look at, but we do have an intelligence and research team, the policy team for Merseytravel, who engage in a lot of policy work and planning work, so including neighbourhood plans, looking at what's going on across the district. Also look at a lot of research, customer research work, etc., to find out exactly what the demographics are across the region, social, economic, employment, etc. And they pull a lot of that information together that can be used, you know, to make the decisions and, yeah, hopefully get some of the impression of what people are currently customers or still in need somewhere, or we can design our services around that. I'd say that team exists, and there's probably a lot of work that they do that might be of interest to you to have that presented to you, which I don't think would be a problem at all. If that was a request for future meetings, we could fit that onto the timetable too. And just back to, again, this report and the way we handle data in Merseytravel at the moment. We have a lot of data on a lot of different things, some of which is fantastic, some of which we perhaps don't need any part of our refinement, how we manage data. We're going to try and bring data, including research like that, together into this electronic system so that it is available and accessible not only to officers, directors, as they're developing and managing the services, but also to members like yourself, so you can drop in and see exactly what we're doing. But yeah, we do have a research and intelligence team that do work on those areas of work. We'd be quite happy to ask them to come let you know.
Thanks for that, Steve. This also, Patrick, links in with our customer forums, because, you know, you've got the local plans, customer forums, regularly advertised, they go to all the different districts. I mean, there's one goal in place now, going to different hospitals, colleges, etc. But we do have the local customer forums. So you can direct people to those. They can ask all these questions, and you have all the relevant offices at those. And these are the things that we've been trying to sort of get more people to engage with, the customer forums, so they can tell us what they want, so as then how we can deliver their needs. That's, you know, this would be a good way to reach out to more people through the customer world. Thanks, Patrick. Anything else? Any more questions? Okay, Stephen, thank you. Thanks very much. Can I ask you to approve the recommendations on paragraph 2? Do you agree? Thank you very much. inside information. We've just had an update on that with upstairs, so I hope members were happy with that, and that is obviously will be progressing, and as we get better with that, hopefully we'll get it out to the wider public. Any questions on that? No? Thank you. Right, item six. I've got no items of any other urgent business. Can I thank you for your attendance, participation, and for the contribution. Thank you.